check out that beauty. Charger dampener, RCT3 for the Yari to turn it into a Lyric Ultimate. All right, so what does it come with? We've got some parts here, some stickers, low speed control, high speed control. I've been wanting to do this for a long time. I have the Yari 2017 170 mil travel. And I think I have mentioned in another video, I think the Ojai video, that I do have the upgraded air spring. So I've done that upgrade. And then now I'm going to do the charger dampener. Supposedly it makes it into equivalent to a Lyric Ultimate, minus the crown. I know on the Lyric, this is hollowed, a little bit lighter weight, but basically the same shock. All right, let's get started. All right, here's some basic tools you're going to need. You're going to need, of course, your Loctite, your grease. You got some Slick Honey. It's old, but it really works. Some high performance suspension fluid, RockShox. I hope I have enough. I don't think I do. So this might be a to be continued. Unless some of my buddies come through and they have some parts. Of course, your Allen wrenches. I don't know if you'll need that star nut, but this thing has everything. A pencil to record your suspension pressures, which I'm gonna do. And a 24 millimeter socket to take off that, take out the old dampener. All right. All right, first thing you do is you want to release that air after you get your recording. I had it at 70 PSI, or 72, something around there. Okay, now I'm gonna disassemble everything. I'm gonna take the fork completely off, just to make it easier. All right, that wasn't so bad. Now I got these out. I'm gonna stick them in here. Make this job a little bit easier. There you go. All right, first thing you wanna do is pull this rebound switch out. Remember your rebound settings too. Then you're gonna loosen this and loosen this. Give them a couple turns, not all the way out, because you're gonna need to break them loose. And I have a towel directly underneath this, because there will be oil coming out. Give these a little tap with a mallet, preferably. Then continue unloosing all the way. Now they should pull right out. Check that out. A little bit of oil, not bad. All right, give it a nice wipe down. Get all that old dust out of there. You can see right here, I've already replaced that spring, the air spring, $40 part. If you have an older Yari or a Pike, I recommend doing it. That really did improve my ride. But this new dampener supposedly going to be a night and day difference. All right, so you want to reposition your forks because this is full of oil. So I got a towel under mine to catch whatever I spill, hopefully not too much. And you're going to need a 2 millimeter Allen key to remove this cap. Yay! Bye-bye, old cap. Wow, that is dirty. Okay, now we need that 24 millimeter socket to remove this upper. All right, let me grab that. All right, I'm gonna clean this cap off. Just, I don't want any debris falling down inside there. Plus, I wanna see what I'm doing, so. This definitely has needed to be done. Like I said, I don't know if I mentioned, it's a 2017 Yari, 170 mil travel. I guess this damper works also on the Lyric and the Pike. All right, 24 millimeter socket. Here we go. Oh yeah, baby. Nice and easy. All right, not bad. All right, I don't know if you can see down in there. Right. There. But I was having a hard time getting this piece out. So this is what happened. This came out. That doesn't look right. All these little pieces came out of it. So hopefully the inside of my, see that? Tore it up. Not that I'm gonna save that part, but it would not pull out. I got oil all over my nice new slippers. Come on. All right, let's see what we gotta do. All right, this is my tool I made before to clean the inside of my tubes, uppers and all that. So what I did was I jammed this in here. Well, I didn't jam it in, but I blasted that part right out of the top of that crown right there. And it landed somewhere over here. Where is it? In here. Check this out. It's got some dog hair. Hi. Jace, no. Check that out. No. That shaft is broken. No. Has it been like that the whole time? And that's one hell of a spacer. All right, hope nothing's damaged, but had some trouble getting that out. All right, let's continue. All right, so these inside of the leg. Actually looks pretty clean, no damage. One thing I skipped, I didn't show you guys because I was a little bit frustrated. This clip does go inside here. So I just pulled that out, similar to this right here, using the proper tool. So once I pulled this out, that bottom shaft comes out that you see laying there on the ground. Using this tool right here. Oh wait, wrong one. Some of these right here. All right. Had to make a run to the LBS. They hooked me up. Some grease. Some, what is this? Suspension fluid. I was a little bit short. They just gave me this bottle. It's like half full. Super nice of them. And what I needed was a tool to torque that on to 28 newton meters, my bad. Yeah, I thought I had the crank puller tool, but it was for race face cranks. So yeah. And they did this for free. Super nice. Track of Ventura. And while I was there, had to grab some Chick-fil-A. All right, so we got all these little parts dumped out of that bag, along with that cool sticker. So this little O-ring goes right in there. And then I'm gonna put the top cap back on. Open, pedal, firm. This is your high and low speed. I'll mess with that once I get it all set up. All right, that's it. It's in. You don't have to put that clip back on here. I guess it just sits in there like that. There it is. Charger dampener 2.1 RCT3. Now I just got to reassemble the lower legs. I got new wiper seals, new foam rings. Got my assembly grease. And I got my suspension fluid. 10 mils on each side. All right. All right, I'm removing my old dust seals. Easiest way to do it. There you go. Wipe them out really good before you replace them with the new seals. Looks pretty good. This is the lower leg tool that I made just to clean these up. Got a little rag on it, PVC. Sorry. So this is just the tool I made, PVC with a rag on it to clean my lowers. It's like a giant Q-tip. Half inch PVC.
They didn't have shoes on.
Okay. Go. Ooh, yeah. Look at that. My old wipers and dust seals. Pretty nasty. Time for some new ones. All right. So you want to take your foam seals. Get them nice and soaked in that lower fork oil before you install them. And then install them down in here. Like so. All right, I'm gonna push these in, these seals with this tool. And you don't want to go too far, just nice and flush. All right, so I'm gonna put the lowers on. Just gonna put a little bit of grease on here to get it started. Not much. Don't be shy with the grease. All right, there we go. There she is. All right. All right. Now you're going to want to tuck this up. Because now we're going to add our 10 mLs. All right, you can see the bottom of the dampeners right inside there. So I'm gonna pull the fork legs away from that so I can inject my oil. All right, we got our 10 mLs. there's a rebound side. There you go. This new rebound switch does come with a set screw right there. So make sure you tighten that once you place it on there. Don't forget blue Loctite. That's it. All right, now that's all that's left is putting this all back on my bike. Charger dampener 2.1 RCT3 or RTC3. I'm ready to roll. Alright, everyone, thanks for watching. I didn't do the best job at this, but got it done. Now I just got to test it out. Alright, so stay tuned for that ride. I'll let you know how it worked out. Thanks for watching, everyone. Stay stoked. All right, as you can see, I had to get a lot of crap out, but it's done. The bike rides really well. Just rode it around the block. I won't really know how good it is until I take it off-road, but man, it felt super plush, way better than it ever has felt. So yeah, that's it. Just adjusted the brakes. I don't need to show you guys how to do that, but everything's adjusted. Everything's tight. Gonna throw a couple zip ties on this brake cable or brake hose. But that's it. All right. Thank you for watching. Stay stoked.